Good night, Tru, Papua New Guinea. Thank you, Tru, for tuning in to Sports Scene. Look, this week, well, over the weekend and into this week, it's been productive in sports, yet a sad one for the whole of PNG. Lawrence, with the passing of the late Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare, the country is in mourning, and it's a great loss for this country.
No, absolutely. Dini, a very good evening to everyone. Condolences. We all sympathize with the Somare family on the passing of this great visionary leader, Sir Michael Somare. So, yep, our condolences to the family.
So, on that, we will also show a little bit on that with sporting bodies sharing their tributes and their condolence messages as well. Also on the show, we talk of the Women's National Soccer League, and they're actually heading into finals. And Tala and Tomsi from Tru Warrior Boxing will join us later in studio. Lawrence, the scoreline, please.
All right, thanks, Dini. Let's go straight into the scoreline. And first up, the Women's National Soccer League. Northern Conference over the weekend, Barra, big winners over Pacific Gardens FC 7-0. Even bigger win, Sipik FC 12-0 against Morobe Tulip FC, Poro FC 4-1 against Makam Rains FC, and Tuspab Ladamon FC 3-0 against Rainy Lay FC. Southern Conference in Port Moresby, Palm City FC 5-1 against Palm City Academy, the NCD FC 3-1 against Amoana FC, and NCD Hekari United FC 3-1 against FC Genesis. Now, to the points ladder, this is how it's looking. Poro FC, I tell you what, these girls, and also Sipik FC, 39-31, and then running off the top three there, Barra there, at the bottom of the ladder, Pacific Gardens, Rainy Lay after round 13. Now the Southern Conference points ladder, FC Genesis, they lost last week, got Hekari United just up there, but FC Genesis still holding on to the points, the top of the ladder, they're 25. And Amoana, a tough season for them, but I'm sure they'll learn from that. Now, there wasn't any fully loaded women's softball, and that is, of course, in respect to the late Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare, that they didn't play any games and won't do so until the end of the mourning period.
And that's it. Still on NSL, earlier we spoke to Paul Isarua. Let's take a look at that, Ivy. I'm here with PNGFA Competitions Director, Paul Isarua. Paul, thank you so much for joining me.
I'm happy to be with you this afternoon.
All right. Ignore the fact that he's taller than me. We'll continue on with the interview. We know the finals is nearing. Tell us about the arrangement with the finals. When will we get to see the Northern Conference appear in Moresby, and when will we get to see the Southern Conference make an appearance in Lae?
Thank you, Dini. It's been an exciting period of football for women. And as we are now winding up the normal competition matches in both the Southern and Northern Conference, we have decided to take the semi-finals to Lae, which means the two top teams of each conference will both be in Lae to battle it out in the semi-finals. The first take the second, and the second place plays the first, vice versa. And that's on the 13th of March. After the semi-finals, we bring the finals back to Port Moresby on the 20th. So we're giving the opportunity for fans in the northern region, that part of the country, to see the two top teams of the southern region, Southern Conference. And then when it comes to the finals time, the Southern Region fans get to see the two top teams from the Northern Conference.
And finally, the launching of Women's NSL, it got off to a great start, and it's been how many months of just pure good football happening?
Yes, like I said in first place, it's been an exciting period for football. Under the leadership of President John Capinato, he has urged us to make sure that our football activities be consistent, get revamped, like the Women's National Soccer League, and then keep them going on an annual basis. In that regard, it is also good for the development of football in the country. For the women, it's a big time for them. We're looking at hosting a good semi-finals, and also the finals here will be very exciting. We look forward to giving them that precedence and finishing the season off on a high note.
Okay, that's it. Paul Isoro from PNGFA. We'll go for a break now and we'll be back with more on Sports Scene. Welcome back. You're watching Sports Scene. The late Grand Chief Sir Michael Thomas Somare stood for unity, and that is something sports has always encouraged.
For a country as diverse as Papua New Guinea, the Founding Fathers' captainship brought people of over 800 language speakers and over 1,000 tribes together when this country became one country through independence in 1975.
I stand here as an optimistic Papua New Guinean, proud of many accomplishments as a nation. We progress through many waves and changes in the world. We survived our own bad decisions. We have united at times when the world thought it was not possible to do so. We must be thankful, and we must always count our blessings.
For the sportsmen and women, and even some of us in the stands, it has always been a matter of pride when the flag is carried during walkouts, at opening ceremony of sporting events around the world, or even during a medal ceremony when the Papua New Guinea flag is raised.
Very proud moment for this great champion from Papua New Guinea.
The PNG pride when Ryan Pinney won gold at the Commonwealth Games in 2006.
Papua New Guinea has taken gold!
Stephen Curry taking gold at the Commonwealth Games in 2018. And even when Toya Whistle became the Queen of the Pacific, to name only a few, we celebrated the PNG pride. Sir Michael Thomas Somare fought for independence. He stood for unity, dignity, and this very pride we celebrate today in sports and all else. As we mourn the loss of this visionary leader, the founding father, the sports fraternity mourns with the rest of the nation.
In father of the nation, late Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare.
I think for me, especially, it is a great loss to this country. As I grew up as a young boy and going to primary schools in the early 70s, I hear of Michael Thomas Somare as the Prime Minister of this country. And grew up as a young boy and going to high school and hearing about the great man he was. And the Prime Minister that brought independence to this country. And being a first politician, a person that has a great vision of this country when people didn't believe that he would take this nation and bring independence. And for me personally, I take my hat off for the grand late Grand Chief Michael Somare, the former Prime Minister. I think he's done a lot for this nation, and it is a big loss to this country. I've been involved in a lot of projects in the mines and oils and oil fields and gas fields, and I worked very closely with his government in the early days as a young man. But great leaders will leave this nation as time comes to an end. But for us in the sports field, on behalf of Papua New Guinea Football Association, we take this time to convey our condolence to the family, to every one of the families of late Grand Chief Somare. We thank the family and the people of ISIPIC, and all the people that one man stood and took this country with the collective leaders, we pay respect to that. And I think Grand Chief, it is an honor for him to lead this nation. And for Papua New Guinea Football Association, on behalf of all the 18 members throughout this country and all the young people playing football out there, we, on behalf of them, we convey the condolence and to the family of late Grand Chief. And it is a great loss.
We honor and pay tribute to a remarkable man, Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare, the father of our nation, one of the greatest men that ever lived and walked our land. We have so much to thank him for in devoting his life, leading and serving our nation. His conviction and legacy will continue to inspire us and the generations to come. Our prayers and thoughts are with his family, the Somare family. May he rest in eternal peace.
I am Yamulauna from Papua New Guinea Olympian Association. And on behalf of its members of the association, we would like to send our sincere condolences to Lady Veronica Somare, her grandchildren and children of the late Sir Michael Somare. Sir Michael was a great leader who always wanted gender equality, and he made sure that the policies he made on gender equality were implemented as well. He's a great leader who has a lot of time for women. In 2008, during his time, he appointed about 10 departmental heads who were women, and I'm one of them, and I would like to thank him sincerely for giving me that opportunity to elevate in my job. With that, I'd like to say bye, and may your soul rest in peace.
Hi, I'm Carol Lelai, the president of the Basketball Federation of Papua New Guinea. On behalf of our board and management, our member associations all around Papua New Guinea, our sponsors Team Up and the International Basketball Foundation, FIBA, and all our supporters, players, coaches, and family members throughout Papua New Guinea, we express our sincere condolences to Lady Veronica and the Somare family on the passing of our first ever Grand Chief, Sir Michael Somare. We also acknowledge and honor the visionary and strong leadership of our Grand Chief, not only in Papua New Guinea, but regionally and the world. We join our fellow sports in paying tribute to his life of service to Papua New Guinea and the invaluable legacies that he has left behind for us and for our children. Together with our fellow sports, we will continue to promote unity in diversity and strengthen our Papua New Guinean bonds throughout our great nation. Rest in peace, Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare.
Like I've mentioned earlier, a great loss for Papua New Guinea, Laurie. Our condolences to Lady Veronica and the children and the grandchildren. I would say for myself, I'm privileged to, you know, be here around a time I got to, you know, meet Somare, came across Somare in my lifetime. Mm. And that's something I will tell my children as well.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's something that, you know, when we had the public holiday, earlier on this week, I asked my kids, you know, do you know why we're having a public holiday? And do you know why we're sort of in this time of sadness and mourning? You know, we're just talking offset there that how much Sir Michael Thomas Somare was such a visionary. I mean, at 30, at early 30s, pre-independence and independence, what he thought and what he has been able to, you know, fought for democracy, unity, We're here as a country, free to do the things we want to do.
That's right. Yeah. We'll go for a break now, and we'll be back with more on Sports Scene.
All right, welcome back. You are watching Sports Scene. We're going to be talking boxing now. Well, Tru Warrior, and with us is Tala Kami and also Tomsi Kami in the studio. Morning, fellas. Morning.
Morning.
Cheese. I said morning. Good night. Good night to you all.
And we said morning back.
and you said morning back. Yeah. Oh, man. Let me first say you guys are looking really nice in your Pacific flower shirts, you know.
Thank you.
Man, you just put me on the spot. You know? I'm nicely all dressed up in a suit. But look, let me first of all say congratulations on hosting the first boxing tournament.
Thank you.
Man, how did that go? And please tell us more about it.
Yeah, it was the first one since last year, January. Yeah.
2020 January.
Okay. Obviously, because of COVID, there was about 11 months where there were no boxing tournaments at all. Mm. And so, you know, it was just good to finally get back, you know, get all the fighters get back in the ring. You know, you train hard and you train because you want to fight. So, you know.
Yeah. You know, I got to say, you know, did really well having that tournament, or having the fights back on again, getting some normalcy back in there, back into normal things. Now, who's involved? Who are the people that are involved, you know, with your boxing tourney?
Which clubs did we have this year?
So we had the Defense Club, based down at Murray Barracks, Integrated MMA, Rabaul Rocks, and also Legend Club, that's the Martin Benny, the legend himself, team as well.
Wow. You know, I was going to say, I mean, but do you get a lot of some interest, like, from the villages and, you know, surrounding areas about boxing?
Yeah, we do. Yeah. We get a lot of messages on our Facebook.
Yeah.
Emails coming through.
They want to be the next boxer. All right. And that's my next question. You know, what's participation like, you know, within the boxing fraternity here in Moresby or Papua New Guinea overall?
It's definitely growing.
Yeah.
Every tournament we host, there's certain fighters that miss out. There's always going to be fights that miss out because we've only got a certain 3 hours or 4 hours to put on fights.
Yep.
So there's enough fighters to be able to turn down fighters. Yeah. So we try to pick the best, most entertaining fights that we can.
And of course, making them register to one of those clubs, the Tarama Club or, you know, Martin Benny's club. And, you know, so they come through a system,
That's right.
So you can't sort of, like, if you're a boxer, you can't sort of come individually. It's got to be through.
Yeah.
Depends, yeah?
Generally speaking, depends who they are.
Yeah.
If we know who they are and they're not part of a club at the moment, then, you know, we still might let them fight. But if we don't know who they are, then we, you know, it's better that they come through a club. So we can find out from the coaches if they can actually box or, you know, their level of experience.
Now Tru Warrior Boxing, guys, what are you guys sort of trying to achieve? What's your sort of long-term goal that you want to see this excel in?
So far, we've got like a group of fighters now that we've been developing for a while. So we've been building up our club for a few years now.
Yep.
And we just want to grow the sport in PNG and get, you know, the viewership up, get people excited about boxing and wanting to come down and just get involved, you know, supporting the clubs and supporting the fighters.
The last one was held last month, the last day of January.
Yep.
How was that, like, overall? Well, you know, after 2020 January, a whole 12 months, you know, how was that event for you?
It was really good. We had a really big crowd.
Yep.
I can't confirm the exact numbers, but it was packed.
Yep.
We had all the clubs that participated all put their best fighters in. So we had some of the top elite amateurs in PNG taking part. Nice. So,
okay. So what's coming up? What's in store for Tru Warrior Boxing? When's our next event?
The next one is March 14th.
Okay.
March 14th at La Mana Gold Club once more.
Yep.
And it's going to be
the divisions in that, the lightweight and
all the way from lightweight up to if we find some heavyweights, then there'll be some heavyweights there, but. As well as a few
females. You say heavyweight and you're looking at me.
People pay big money to see.
I'd do a bit of that, but, you know, we'll save that for another time.
That's right.
Okay, so March 14, and then, of course, you're going to try and do this what, every 3 months, every so often, or?
Yeah, every 2 months.
Yeah, 2 months. Yeah,
I think 2 months is a good period. It allows us to sort of revamp, regroup, and then if any new boxers want to trade out, yep. you have that 2 month period to get a bit of training experience, and then you step in the ring.
Is there any plans for you to go rural, like out in the villages to promote it with the village people, you know, there?
Yeah, definitely. We definitely think along those lines. Mm. And hopefully, after we build up some hype with the city shows, we can move out and go out to the outside villages and that, and host tournaments, fights there as well.
Yeah, awesome. Tala, Tomsi, we're going to have to wrap it up. But before we do, Tala, I'll just give you this opportunity to, say your message out there to the public and, what Tru Warrior is all about.
Sure.
Yeah.
First of all, I'd just like to say thank you to Lamana Gold Club for being the major sponsor of all our fights and providing a venue, providing a ring and a place for the fights to take place. So thank you very much, Lamana. Apart from that, all of the fights are pretty much organized just by ourselves with our own sort of funds and our own materials. So if there's any companies that feel that this is an opportunity, they want to jump on board and help and sponsor, this is a great opportunity to get involved with grassroots sports, right down to the level of, young boys and girls who are trying to, do something good with their lives, do something positive with their lives. So please, hit us up on Facebook. We're on Facebook, Tru Warrior PNG. Send us a message if you want to get in touch. But otherwise, we'll see you guys down at the show on March 14th. Come on down and watch some of the best PNG elite amateur boxers take part in Tru Warrior Boxing.
Awesome. Thanks, Tala. Tomsi, thanks so much.
Thank you very much.
All right, we'll wrap things up here and take a short time out. We'll be back with more of Sports Scene.
Welcome back. You're watching Sports Scene. Unfortunately, this is the last segment on the show tonight. We'll just run through what's coming up this week in Lawrence.
All right. Thanks, Dini. Let's run through what we're going through this weekend. And it's just in the Northern Conference. Their game's on this Saturday in Lae, Sipik FC versus Poro FC, Rainy Lae FC at 1 p.m. against Moraba Tulip FC. At 3 p.m., two games played at the same time. Bara FC versus Makam Rains and Pacific Gardens FC take on Tuspab Lattimore. All right, so those are the fixtures. No games in the Southern Conference. They finished their games last week. They'll meet up in the finals the following week. It's a top two from Northern and a top two from Southern. They meet in the finals. So, yeah, good luck to the girls playing this weekend.
Absolutely. Now, for Fully Loaded Softball, I know we've been putting up their fixtures every week. For this weekend, though, they've called off the fixtures in respect to the country being in mourning over the death of the late Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare. So I think for a number of sporting activities, we'll be hearing those sort of announcements from in the coming days. I think that's it, Lawrence. Yeah. Anything else you would like to tell of yours?
I think that's about it. We will now contact us, huh?
Yes.
If you do have any sporting stories or draws or results you want us to air out, we can be able to do that. I'll read through this.
Yeah, sure.
Contact us here at MTV on 312-9200, or you can visit our Facebook page. Do like the page as well, Sports Scene TV on our Facebook page, or you can email us as well, sports@mtv.com.pg.
All right, so for those in Port Moresby, still uncertain times ahead due to COVID-19, so we would not encourage you to drop by at Garden City. Please utilize any of the means that was just on screen. You can call us or email us, all of that, and let us know your story tape, and we would be more than happy to assist you. I think that's about it. This has been another episode of Sports Scene. Do join us same time, same place next week. Bye for now.
Good night.